delivery services. The who?
Looking at Yankee stats, 1927 to present.
Ustream's going down again.
It's yeah. We're not getting it back.
Fuck Ustream. They're always doing. They probably the feds probably shut them down. What do you think? They're spraying the clouds right now over this motherfucker Eddie Bravo. Look, Eddie Bravo's new fucking.
Can you turn the Wi-Fi off on your phone, Ari?
What?
Can you turn the Wi-Fi off on whatever that was?
Why? What's the problem?
Why?
Because I'm trying to make sure that the things would be okay.
Look at the shape of you. You're not gonna get your little purple shirt. Where's that half a sandwich my wife made you?
Yeah, where's that half a sandwich?
I have no idea.
Where is that fucking thing?
It's probably in the car.
You guys can eat on that shit?
No, but sometimes you have to eat to tame the tiger a little bit. You know what I'm saying? You got to do some things sometimes that you don't want to do. You know what I'm saying? Who are you texting, cocksucker?
He told me to turn the Wi-Fi off.
Jesus Christ. I got no Wi-Fi on my phone. I could even send pictures.
Okay.
I had a picture I want to send to two people fainting. I couldn't send the picture. What's up with you? Everything all right?
Everything's good.
Oh, this is great.
How you feeling, dog?
Solid.
Want to turn the lights off and put on
Yeah, the lights are too bright.
Is that what you think?
Oh, yeah, if anything. Yeah,
turn them off. They're right there.
Just turn them off. What are you
At least
for?
Down. Oh,
see, like that.
Yeah.
Nice. That's what you fucking need in your life. Who are you texting?
No, okay.
Who are you texting already?
I'm trying to make it brighter.
Is Paula watching?
Probably not, hopefully.
All right, hopefully the fucking thing. Then what's going on with you, Eddie Bravo? The World 10 Planet. When is the next EBI? December?
Next EBI, EBI 5, is Sunday, December 13th.
I was close.
Downtown LA at the Orpheum once again. Beautiful theater. It's a great place to see a show. And this time we're doing one 16-man bracket, the lightweights. Danny Prokopos is the champion. We got Eddie Cummings, who is our featherweight champion, moving up in weight and trying to take that lightweight belt as well.
How's Denny doing?
Denny's doing great.
Yeah?
He's doing great. Training his ass off.
Hell yeah. Yeah. What's he do now?
He has his, you know, he runs 10th Planet San Francisco.
Oh, cool.
And, you know, he's a very busy man when it comes to jiu-jitsu. I mean, he's always training, always teaching. He's a
You think of how many schools have popped around the area.
Yeah.
You know, thank God that he has a great system. But how many fucking people, every fucking day I hear somebody opening up a new fucking school. It's like hotcakes, man. So you're out there fighting every fucking day. The leopards are at your door.
What?
You're trying to keep a fucking jiu-jitsu school open. It's not like it used to. You're trying to charge this. This guy wants to charge this. He's beating you out by $40. People sign up. Then they steal your identity and sell it to the Brazilians. Then you got to start from scratch. Now you're back in an American school. You know how the fucking thing goes. It's always a nightmare. One minute you're fucking buying a year subscription to a jiu-jitsu school. The next thing you know, you're buying an acai bowl in Rio de Janeiro. You don't even have a fucking passport. What the fuck is going on here?
Here, Joey, give me your phone.
Why? I ain't putting the lights on. Leave the light alone. This ain't no fucking Yes concert, cocksucker. Right away, he wants to put lights on like this is Led Zeppelin in concert. Turn the lights off.
What
the fuck is wrong with you? Leave the, we got a candle. That's it.
Okay.
Or you could just leave your phone on with the light up and just put it on the desk.
Who gives a fuck about it? Listen, we got no Ustream. We might as well do this.
No, we got it. We got it now.
All right, then what the fuck, people? You with us or what?
We got night vision on these cameras?
We got night vision on these motherfuckers. I'm sorry, people. We can't spark up a number in here. We just can't tap out this way. We like this place. It's nice and family. We can go outside and smoke a number in the darkness.
We can Periscope. Mid podcast Periscope.
We could podcast Periscope.
Please play that song.
Which one? What's what the fuck is that?
I need more information.
You need some vocals. Like, you need some drums.
Anybody on Twitter know what that song is?
Yeah, just like that. Guess the fucking.
Gone. It's gone.
All of a sudden, it's Jeopardy. What's going on, Eddie Bravo? Talk to me. Fucking Ari's passed out. He's over here thinking about Saigon. And look at him. Lee Syatt's got his purple shirt on, giggling up a storm. Put the light back on. Now we're going to fucking fall asleep here. He's going to put the light on. I'm getting scared. Yeah. That shit scares the shit out of me, dog, at night. I don't like it.
You get scared, too?
Sometimes I'm going to leave the fucking house, dog. That's what my paranoia. That's
what?
My old
on Halloween?
Halloween's the least of my problems. I'm talking about 7 4 in the morning when you're snorting an 8-ball and you're looking for a Coke Rock under your carpet. And you think the DEA's watching you. Halloween, Halloween can suck my dick. I was in the halfway house, and I would go home for furloughs in Boulder.
Why?
And my wife, listen to me.
You've already done that life.
Listen to me. My wife was pregnant at the time. I would come home Fridays at 6.
Wait, you had a pregnant wife? Coming home from what?
Listen to me. In the halfway house. listen to me.
Did you miss it already?
I'd fucking come home on Fridays. I'd eat dinner with her like a normal family. She'd go to bed pregnant by 9 o'clock to get the itch in my neck. I'd make the call. A guy would deliver an 8-ball. I'd put a leash on the dog and make believe I was taking the dog for a walk, and I got like a 12-pack of Coors, and I'd hide each can in the fucking snow. You know how we do it, Doug. I'd hide each can in the fucking snow.
You know what?
I'd go to the liquor store, and I'd buy 12 cans of Coors.
Okay.
You hide. I'd come back, and I'd take each can out of the wrapper and put them into the snow.
Okay.
On this side, so I knew I had drank them already, right?
Yeah.
I'd do a couple bumps, and I'd go back in the house, and she'd fall asleep. I'd do 2 or 3 lines, I'd watch a porno, and I'd let the dog out to pee. And then I'd take a beer, crack it open, and drink it real fast, and hide the beer. I would do this all night. I would get so thirsty, I would have to let the dog out to pee. You know what it is? When you're 9th beer, when you're paranoid as fuck, and you want a dog, you have no idea what it's like to open up your front door. You have no idea what paranoia is when you think the DEA is waiting on the other end. I remember one weekend, I did so much coke, I wouldn't even let the dog out to pee. He sat by the door. You could see the pee dripping out of his fucking ears before I opened up that door. 2 days I didn't open up that fucking door.
What?
2 days in Aspen. He finally peed in the hallway. He broke down, and he shit, and I had to pick it up the next day. But I wouldn't open that door. I was so fucking paranoid.
Really?
Yeah.
You left him out there? You left your dog out there?
No. I let him back in the house. Yeah. Then there was one point I wasn't opening up the door no more. Either you're in or you're out, cocksucker.
Yeah.
And once you go out, there ain't no coming back in. So get back in, because you're going to drive me crazy all fucking night. What the fuck are you giggling about? Nobody even said
what
nothing.
What are we talking about?
We're not talking about nothing. Just look at the screen. Make believe you're looking for Martians or Matt Damon or whatever the fuck you're looking for.
Play Adventure Time.
Yeah. Oh, and it was a song that we opened the podcast with. Is a song that Ari was singing.
What?
Boom, boom, boom.
Hand of Doom.
What? Who is it?
Black Sabbath.
Oh, really?
Yeah, it's Hand of Doom. It's what we started with.
That's where it is.
Look at the fuck. What time is your spot at the store?
So, I don't know.
Who gives a fuck? You want me to call him and tell him, listen, don't wait on Ari.
Tell him, don't wait on Ari.
It's over. Ugh. So what are you thinking, guys? I thought people would be jumping out windows. Nobody's doing dick
yet. I want to jump out of a window.
I'm sure you do. You have a fucking cake.
Play some music.
Okay.
Yeah, play some music. Put that fucking...
What? On that or on this?
What is this, a party? I'm gonna put this fucking... He shows up with a jukebox.
You said
that his mother bought him fucking when he was 12. I can't believe you bought that out.
Play something if you got it.
It's desktop speakers.
How old are these fucking things?
I don't know, like 4 years old.
You can't just play anything on your computer?
I know I can, but we didn't want to get taken off of YouTube.
What the fuck?
What do you want to play? What do you want to play?
This ain't no goddamn music podcast. I'm trying to talk to Ari and Eddie Bravo. They got to step up to the pump. Get up, cocksucker. Stand straight. Wake up. We're talking here. Where's that half a sandwich? Wake him up.
I took my car.
Jesus Christ. The whole... What's that?
What's that?
What's what? What's that? What's that what? You had a piece of acid?
No, yeah.
We ate it.
No, when did that happen?
10 minutes ago. You didn't even see it go down. That's how smooth I am.
Wait, what?
It's so smooth.
Nobody saw it. Check your bottle caps. You thought Cosby went to work. Check your bottle caps. Look at Eddie looking at his water. What are you talking about? I can't teach an armbar when I'm... Yes, you can, cocksucker.
Oh, my God.
What's the matter, dog? Look at the shape of you. Your head's purple. You got blotches. You got to sit up straight.
This I'm fine.
It. Nobody wants to chitter-chatter? That's it. You want to go outside and stand outside and get some air? And periscope it? And look at people on the street?
No. Fuck that.
Let's go look at people on the street. We stand out there long enough, we might see a hooker. Like a white hooker walk by.
Really?
They got hookers out here?
Up deep. They walk weird.
What?
They lurk. They make believe they're
going
in
and out. What do you mean they lurk?
Hookers love In and Out Burger.
Oh, I always see them at grocery stores.
Yeah, cocksuckers love In and Out Burger.
Out here, around here, huh?
There was one the other day in Lancashire. In and Out Burger. Yeah, there was one the other day in Lancashire that had a black dress on, a black one. That was beautiful.
Yeah?
You could see she wasn't fucking around. She was going for dollars. I was watching it from the light. I was just watching. I go, oh, look at this freak. She's got the wig on. She got the whole thing.
So how come she doesn't get arrested right away?
Because she's doing it right. She's probably got something under her arm. She's looking for something in the neighborhood. But she's mingling. We see them all the time. We used to see the black one. They used to walk around fucking Riverside all the time.
With the blonde hair?
With the blonde hair for years. 10 in the morning. 10 in the morning. She'd walk around the YMCA. You'd see her. I'd see her. I'd be at the park fucking walking the baby in the carriage.
I used to live on Sherman Way in Sepulveda, and that's like where they
Well, that's out. Where that's the headquarters. Like, that's
and I would go back at night, like at 2 in the morning, and just be out.
No, I'm talking Studio City on those little streets. You see them. They're out there. They're just lurking low-key and shit. They hang out by Whole Foods.
How do you know they're hookers?
Because I saw the black girl working it one day. And then I saw her.
Did she make an eye contact, what? Right?
No, she didn't make eye contact with me. I saw how she got another guy, an older guy, to lure her at Whole Foods. You know when you just get something to eat and you park in your car and you sit there for a few minutes and you eat it?
Yeah,
and you're just looking at everybody. Just looking to the parking lot. You're not looking. You're just looking at the parking lot, bro. Yeah. That's what you're there. You're just looking. And I saw her come in. I saw her walk in, walk out, and she went to the driveway. The guy got in his car with his groceries, picked her up, and took her.
What?
And then I started seeing her more and more. And then I was
where? Whole Foods?
Right by Whole Foods, whatever
that
is.
They do it at Ralph's all the time.
No. What's the one
what's
by...
What's up with supermarkets?
What's the one by the fucking... What's the white one by Laurel Canyon?
Trader Joe's.
Maybe it's a hot place.
Just public
Whole
place.
Whole Foods and Trader Joe's.
The hot one by Riverside. By what's down the block from the Marie ETC?
Yeah.
That's why? Whole Foods.
Whole Foods.
That's Whole Foods. Whole Foods.
Why
is a black chick that hangs out there? Because that's her cover. She's going there to buy something, and she walks in that parking lot. A little old guy comes out, sees her, wants his dick sucked, and she looks. Guys, she can't do that if she's ratty in Studio City.
All right, she's got to look.
She
good.
Looks like.
She gets offered, so she goes around there getting offers.
She looks
seven,
like the,
eight.
She looks like the black girl from the movies from Catwoman.
Halle Berry.
Wait, and she's like hot and she's going to supermarket parking lots of the rich?
Dresses, yep. That's how she does it. I've seen
and just
her.
Like, oh,
I think
and wait for them to hit on her?
Gelson's. Fucking Gelson's.
Wait.
Gelson's.
Is she Ethiopian?
No, she's black. I've never really had a conversation with her, but I've waved at her. She's waved at me. She knows that I know that she knows that I know that she's a hooker. Okay? We used to sit there and drink coffee and she walked by every day. And
she
after a while,
dresses up and hopes to meet Starbucks guys.
Listen, whatever the fuck, she's walking on Riverside and Laurel Canyon.
Yeah,
you're not gonna see crack people walking up
okay,
there. So
okay,
what
okay.
she does is she walks down Riverside.
Yeah,
she sees you by Laurel Canyon. And she walks down to Riverside, and by the time she gets to Colfax, or that following fucking street, you pick her up.
Oh
my God, what a surprise! And then she'll ask you whatever the fuck they ask you. You know whatever the fuck it is that they do. You want to suck my dick? Whatever the fuck they want.
I never did it like this in the bushes.
No, normal people do it like that.
It's crazy how there's just one chick that does it right here in the valley. That's insane.
And I saw her for a long time in the mornings. My wife saw her. My wife knew what she looked like. Then there's another thick black one that I tormented from 7-Eleven. That one that I tormented. She wouldn't even talk to me no more. Because I used to tell her to wait for me on the corner. I'm going to go over there and shove it up your ass and put jelly on it. And she'd call me all night. Where are you? I'll be right there. I'm on the corner. This one, I met her at the HaHa. I met this one at the HaHa. She was at the HaHa one night. Hi, how are you? I'm a comedian. No shit. Nice to meet you. Okay. 2 weeks later, how are you? Nice to meet you. She was another chick. I thought that was kind of weird. They're both comedians. I know comedians, but then again, maybe I don't. I'm not on. At that time, I wasn't hanging around on Sunset Boulevard. Yeah. I didn't know the Comedy Store. And the third time, she goes, I'm booking a room in Chamego, California. Can I text you, whatever? Can I call you? I go, call me with the info. I never fucking even remembered her name, guy. Never remembered her name. And then around the holidays, this is when my wife was either really pregnant or just had the baby. Like, I was in shock. And then one day my phone rang, and she's like, I don't know if you remember me. Not really. And she was like, this is my name. I want to know if you could help me with comedy. And after a few minutes, you know, when you talk to somebody, you remember. I'm like, oh, yeah, I remember me.
Yeah.
And she's like, if you could help me. And you know me, I was just starting to go on the road. I go, listen, I'm on the road. I just had the baby. I don't know if I could go down to the HaHa. Okay, that's it. She left it at that. I didn't hear from her again. Then I get a call from her, bro. Typical hooker shit. She's in a bind.
One quick question. Did you put it in this?
No. She's in a bind. Somebody.
Transmission just blew up.
What was it? Somebody stole her car.
How she know your number?
Because I met her at the bar. I thought she was a regular black chick.
Yeah.
I thought she was a rich. When somebody tells you they're a comic and they're going to book a room, you don't want to be fucking rude. You think that you're going to give them your number and they're never going to call you again, or they're going to text you and you're going to be out of town, or that's it. I didn't fucking think nothing of it. She was a cute girl. She got a cute fucking little Chinese girl, whatever. But I felt something weird. One night, when I first met him, we met some girl. He left with her, and he came back 10 minutes later.
Tell me.
That she wanted him to suck his dick. Bro, you don't know who you bump into in North Hollywood. There's dick suckers out there. Who the fuck knows? I go back to my... I never think about this shit.
What do you mean there's dick suckers out there?
There's dick suckers out there at all hours of the night. You don't fucking know what they want. So she calls me one night. You know when somebody calls you, Eddie, and they want something from you, but they won't tell you? Like, Eddie, I want to train for a month for free. I don't have the money. They're waiting for you to ask them. Then they call you again. And you know they want something. What is it, bro? Well, this happened for like 3 times in 10 days. Yeah. When are you doing comedy again? You know, like when you're busy and you're doing something, your phone rings and you recognize the number, but you don't.
Yeah.
And you go, let me pick it up. And you pick it up and it's like, hi, it's Camille, whatever her fucking name was. Yeah. Are you doing a set anywhere tonight? Ah, you know what? I don't know. Can I call you back, Camille? And then you hang up the phone. Nah, that was it, guys. One night I got a call that her car broke down, if I remember her. No, I don't. And she goes, my car broke down. I need money for something. I'm a DJ.
Yeah.
She hit me with the DJ story first. And I came right back. I go, listen, I got a fucking baby. I'm in no position to whatever. I can't help you out. Okay. Sorry to bother you. And it was too easy. Somebody who really needed $300 would have fucking worked me for it.
Yeah.
Then like a week later, she called again.
What?
And she's like, I got out of the bail. Thank you anyway. Good luck with your family or whatever the fuck. And that was it. And then, I don't even know. Over time, one day, she just called. And I go, listen, man. What the fuck is your problem?
What do you want?
Yeah, like, what is it? It's 1 a.m. Because she switched numbers. So she started calling me with a New York City number. You know that weird number from New York? It's 925.
415 or something?
Something fucking different. So I see New York. I think it's one of my buddies. Bank 2 in the morning. Hi, it's fucking Kamiqua. I want to know. And I asked the one. I said, what the fuck is your problem? And she goes, well, sometimes I turn tricks. You know, I'm 23. And I'm like, oh, I fucking knew it. I just connected this 7 months later. I'm 50. I don't have that. When I'm 20, I would have banged her already. And stabbed her and fucking left her in the desert. But nah, you know what I'm saying? Like, you look at her and you go, yeah, whatever. And then I would see her around town. I'd see her at the 7-Eleven. And then I told her, what, are you fucking crazy? And then me and her bumped into her one night. We were getting something at 7-Eleven. She's like, oh, where you been? And I started talking to her. I got in the car. I go, Lee, that's the hooker. So she called me again like an hour later. Were you doing anything? I go, you know what? Let's finally do this. You know that gym on Lancashire? Meet me right there. Shave your little black pussy. Put a blonde wig on. I just told her 1,000 things. And I said, go there. You know when you get high and you forget about somebody?
Yeah.
Then the phone rings an hour later, like, where the fuck are you, motherfucker? She called me back, and I'm like, what? I ain't picking you up. I just hung up the fucking phone.
Yeah.
Never heard from her again.
Like when Katie calls you.
Guess what?
Katie, yeah. Not right now. What?
Like what's 6 months, like 6 weeks later, she calls me again one night.
Yeah.
Hey, baby, I want to know if you're lonely. Who's this? Shamiqua, whatever. I want to know if you're lonely. I said, you know what I am? Meet me on the corner by the gym. And she's like, okay, what do you want me to wear? And I fucking tormented her. Put heels on, shave your pussy, do this, wash your ass. Okay, baby. An hour later, where the fuck are you? This went on like every 6 weeks for like 2 months. It was hilarious. She finally gave up on me. And one night, me, Steve, Simone are eating at that fucking...
Yeah, like, okay.
She just passed. She knew I was going to leave her out there. I used to slate her the whole time. I was just... tormenting her like Bobby Slade.
I'll be out there in 25 minutes.
I'll be out there in 25 minutes. Wait by the statue. Dog, I used to torment Bobby Slade. It was the best work
Let's
I ever
call
did.
Him up.
We can't call him up, bro. Because now he knows I don't get high. Huh?
What'd you do?
I would fucking, like, he'd call me, give me $200, and he'd say, put the coke under the statue. And I'd put, like, the statue with nothing under there, like an empty envelope. I just fuck with him. He called me. What happened to it? I don't know. I left it there. Yeah, there's an envelope, but it's empty. I don't know what the fuck to tell you.
I was left there.
Don't say this to me. Maybe my kid stole it. Maybe your kid stole it. I don't fucking know. Go check with him. Call me back. I ain't got time for this shit. I would torment him. And then I learned what cities he was in, okay? And I would call him up on Thursday night, and I'd go, you got anything? Do you need anything? And he'd go, why? You got a connection? Yeah. I know big people. I didn't know nobody, Eddie. I knew nobody. And he'd be like in Indiana. Right? He'd be like...
So he thinks he's getting drugs?
Oh, man. Are you sure he's not
wearing a wire? He's just waiting for it. He's like, oh.
Oh, my God.
And how long before he just...
2 years until he finally one day realized I wasn't coming through.
I worked with him once, probably Slayton, in Montreal. The whole time, he kept going like, Ari has already been ducking out early. he was doing blow. That's why he ducks out early. So you gotta watch him. He's got it all.
Oh, my God.
He left him for both of you guys.
So I would call him.
Just all right. Come on, baby.
So I would call him like on a Thursday. He gained trust with me. I took him
just
out.
Just for fun, just by yourself?
You know me, dog. I'm the mind of a devil. When I, there's only one guy who ever bought into me. Rod Long one day called me up. A black
he was
comic.
So chosen all the time.
Listen to
it.
Me. A black comic in Seattle pulled me aside one day and he goes, you should change your business card from comedian to professional torturer. He goes, because that's what you are. Because he had a kid that used to steal his jokes. Count Hopkins III was a black guy with a pink tongue. You know those black people that when they're off on stage, all you see is a pink tongue? He was black, Count Hopkins. He would do Rod Long's jokes, but not really.
What?
He wouldn't do his jokes, but not really. Like, let's say Rod Long said, yeah, I'm sitting on a pier.
Yeah.
And I would see Count Hopkins do, I'm sitting on a pier. We would get right on the phone and call Rod Long and go, Rod Long, he's doing your sitting on a pier joke. No, that Negro isn't. Yes, he is. I'll be right down there, Joe Diaz. He's the only black guy that called me Joe. Oh, my God. He showed up at the club, Joe Diaz. he used to call him a joke buccaneer. Where's that joke buccaneer? Where's that joke buccaneer, Joe Diaz?
What country was he from?
See, he was from Seattle. A little light-skinned black dude that I
love. No, he wasn't. How could he?
Rod Long, good fucking dude. Good dude. Lehigh was up there, too, at the time. We used to talk.
The Bushmen liked to party.
So Bobby Slayton, we're back to Bobby Slayton. So I found out Bobby Slayton was a fiend like me.
Oh, yeah.
So I hooked him with El Compadre. So he would call me, El Compadre. I went down there, the bass player, don't worry about nothing. I hooked him up with the Armenian. Next thing you know, he's having barbecues at the Armenian. Tremendous. He's loving the Armenian. Really? They're over the house. The wife's getting worried. So he would go on the road, and I would call him on Thursdays in the afternoon. I'd say, do you have anything? And he'd go, just a little bit. Why? You know somebody? Who the fuck do you think you're dealing with? I know everybody. I go, where you at? And he'd tell me, I'm in St. Louis, the Hotel Eddie Bravo. I go, all right. I'll call you in 10 minutes. I'd hang up with him. I'd call the hotel back. And I go, how you doing? Is there any landmarks close to your hotel? And they go, yeah, like a mile down. There's like a horse and buggy stand where Abe Lincoln stood. Perfect. And I would call him back and go, listen, I just spoke to the fucking Colombian. What's his name? Don't matter. His name is the Colombian. He's going to meet you over down the corner. And I'd break the address down to him.
Where
this is before the internet, guys. I don't know nothing about the fucking internet.
And just, are you just sitting in a hotel room in a random city by yourself?
I'm in a random city dialing 411, giggling to myself, calling information, calling comedy clubs, calling hotels. Once I know the club, you're doomed. Once I know the club and I know the people at the bar, I'll doom you. Because I know that I would put them on people who didn't do anything with drugs.
Yeah.
And I'd say, go to the bar and wave at the Chinese guy and blink your nose. And he would do that and say, the fucking guy ain't saying nothing back to me. I owned him, Eddie Bravo. I owned him.
You knew specific guys to send him to, but for nothing.
But for nothing. The guys weren't getting high. I would go over there and scratch your nose twice. They'll give you the package. I went over there and scratched my nose. He didn't give me nothing. I'm back in my room. You fucked up. You got nothing tonight. So I would find out, and I'd call him back and go, okay, you're meeting Eddie. All right, you're going to meet him over by the statue. How long? 30 minutes. And he'd go, you know, it's snowing out. I don't give a fuck. You got to meet him outside. I'd put him out there in the fucking snow in Cincinnati, Ohio, in the dead of the winter on a Friday night.
Just get his fix.
To go get his fix. He'd be calling me 45 minutes later. He's not coming. He's not coming. Where are you? Go to the thing and wave your arm. I would tell him to wave his arms.
Torturing.
Then I'd hang up the phone and not answer the phone the rest of the night. He'd call the house 80 times. This is before cell phones. He'd call the house 80 times. Where are you? Pick it up, you fuck. Chino never showed. There was no Chino. I just told him that. I just made up the fucking name in my head. Poor Bobby, dog. Finally, he called on. He was like, I can't take it no more.
You never give me a single lead. You never once let me just a fucking coke.
You could hook him up a couple times.
He what?
The Armenian. I mean,
Yeah, good point. Good point. Yeah, he's got some wins.
That's why you got to give him something. You can't win him out the whole fucking time.
Every fourth one, you give it to him.
You got
to
give him fucking something, you know. I was telling these guys a while ago, I used to shake this Chinese restaurant down.
Oh, my God.
The first walk Chinese restaurant. What happened was I got turned on to Ron. Ron was like a player. He bought neon from my friend.
And
he had this big lounge. So one day I went to Ron. I go, Ron, let's do a comedy show.
Yeah.
This is 94, dog. I had 8 minutes of comedy. And he goes, well, what budget?
What budget?
I go, give me three bills. I'll pay the headliner 100, the other guy 50, and I'll keep the rest, right? We do the show. This guy makes $3,000 at the bar.
Oh, really?
Eddie, he's never made more than 200 at the bar. Selling Mai Tais and shit. This guy kept calling me, Joey, when we do it again? When we do it again? So now, you know me and my cocaine line. Every time I see him, I just make up a name. What do you want to see, Richard Pryor? Yeah, I would see Richard Pryor. Give me 300, let me call his manager right now, and I'll get him here next Friday, and he'll do it. Really, you can do a show? And I did this to this guy for 6 or 7 months. Every week I'd see him, and I go, give me 300, Bill Cosby's coming. Well, Richard Pryor, no come. What happened to Richard Pryor? Listen, Richard Pryor came, but you weren't here. Remember when you went to New Jersey for the... he was here. He was... No, nobody tell me. Oh, I had this guy. I was playing him like a fucking fiddle, dog.
Oh.
I was having a great time with this guy until one day he finally goes, nobody's going to fucking show up.
Yeah.
And he finally goes, I ain't giving you no more fucking...
Oh, yeah. Money.
How great would Chinese food be?
Right now?
Yeah.
If they delivered.
I love those dreams. All those Mexicans got into...
The what?
Free margaritas, all you can eat.
Where?
Whatever the rooms were.
In Felipe's room?
Yeah.
And those guys?
Felipe's rooms, yeah. You can eat your ass off and make like 25, 50 bucks.
Years ago.
Yeah, they were great. Get loaded.
They give you little tacos at the bar. I go down, they give you 40
They're drunk
bucks.
Mexican girls. I didn't know how to appreciate it back then.
No, I would bomb.
It was too much for me.
I would go down and just bomb on principle. But those rooms were fun, man. Yeah. They make you... It's better than just sitting at the store waiting for spots some nights. Some nights you got to fucking go down there and they don't even laugh at you. They didn't want to know fucking white people. That one room changed names so many fucking times.
The Brave Bull?
No, that was Rudy Moreno's room. The one Felipe had with Willie where they got shot at.
Oh, what?
Somebody threw a knife at somebody.
That's where management got chased. Management got chased. They jumped him over a fence.
Yeah, they didn't like fake Mexicans down there. Nothing. Those rooms.
What? Why would you go do comedy there?
Because it's $50 on a Wednesday.
Yeah, you have to, I guess. But no, it's pretty good, though. It's like a real... Usually, it's a good show.
There were good shows.
They drive you out there?
Depending on who was hosting.
Yeah.
You know, those shows were great.
Jeff Garcia was there a lot.
If you were the first three comics to go up in those bar-ass shows, you were great. Anything after that, they're fucking hammered. The Lakers lost.
And Willie Barsena.
Willie Barsena would do an hour and a half, though. In those fucking things.
That was the first I ever saw that he would be like, hey, you might have seen Carlos Mencia do this joke, but it's my joke, so I can do it. No, I can do it. And then he was like, then he would do this joke.
No, he would go up on stage and torment Carlos Mencia in that little room.
Talk about everybody.
Oh my God, he'd talk about everybody.
On stage.
And then he'd smack you.
It was great.
He smacked a couple people down there. He broke somebody's nose and shit. He got banned from the Laugh Factory. He broke somebody's nose at the Laugh Factory.
No way, really?
Yeah, he can't step in the Laugh Factory, will he?
Oh.
The Comedy Store either. Mitzi banned him at the Comedy Store. What's the matter? There's nothing in your water, dog. Unless I'm a fucking octopus. What happened to that head?
I don't know what happened to it.
We
it's
ate
gone.
It.
Yeah,
I told you.
It.
Me, you, now. And Eddie ate it. Eddie, what's wrong with your feet? You're worse than me, cocksucker. You're looking good, Eddie.
You're like Gollum.
42 years old. Look at you.
45.
Looking smooth. You're looking like Metallica when they came back from rehab. Remember they were all clean. Reload. How bad was Metallica, dog? 20 years ago. First time I heard that shit, I didn't even know what the fuck I was listening to.
They cut the hair. Yeah. They got. They had a country song on that album. It's called Load.
What?
And the single was Until It Sleeps. But they got the same shit for the album before, the Black album. Everyone thought they sold out. I'll never forget my friend James telling me that, you know, he heard the new Metallica song, which was Enter Sandman.
Yeah.
And I like the older Metallica. I was young. I was like 18, 19.
The older fast Metallica?
James goes, dude, it sounds like fucking AC/DC. And I'm like, no, Metallica sounds like AC/DC now. And he goes, yes. Oh my God. And then you hear that Sandman. Like, it is like AC fucking DC. Never was into that song. But that's the Black album does have some great shit. Like Sad But True. I gave up. Once I heard Enter Sandman, I'm like, fuck Metallica. I was done.
Really? I'm a Sad But True type of guy, too. That's a badass.
But, you know, then Unforgiven ended up growing on me, and that's a classic. And Nothing Else Matters, that's a ballad, but it's a classic. But I remember being at FM station here in the Valley to see a Kiss cover band, and in between bands, they play music, and they played Sad But True, and I was right by the fucking PA, and they had so cranked. And I thought, holy shit. This motherfucking song is good. Come on, Sad But True.
No, I'm
you can't
with you.
Deny how's that.
How Sad But True.
Start up from the beginning. Oh, start shit. Up from the beginning.
That's
a fucking jam.
I gave up on that album, but that song pulled me back in. That song said, "Oh shit, I gotta go back in."
Metallica. Yeah, let's go. This is deep, dog.
This is one of their best.
Yeah, I love this jam. Monday mornings, this is one of my favorite jams to play.
There you go.
Prick this motherfucker, Lee. Mr. Churchill, what's happening now, cocksucker? Sunday night. Christopher Columbus, you bad motherfucker. Yo. 1-2, Eddie Bravo on the mic. Ari Shaffir giggling.
Yo.
I'm drooling and shit.
Wait, that's it?
Here we go.
There we go. Oh, all right.
I got
you. Oh, yeah, I remember this.
Come on.
Yeah.
That's heavy as fuck.
Here we go, people. It's starting right now.
Yo, here we go now. Hit it, Joey.
This pulled you back in. Heavy.
The chorus is strong as fuck.
Turn the light off. Here we go. Turn this fuck. Crank that shit. Pilot the Bombardier. The Bombardier. Oh shit.
Hit it, Joe.
Who are you texting, Lisa?
I'm a periscope.
You're periscoping? Who the fuck are you periscoping, cocksucker? He's better than you, huh? Want to eat another star of Dutch?
No.
What'd you do with that half a hitter, Sid? Oh, ah. I'm gonna give some shout outs. Keep the music playing, cocksuckers. Oh shit. Michael Marcy, Sierra Realty, Tommy P, David Martinez, Nick Manzarella, Dola, whatever your fucking name is, my main man, Matt Baltazar, Leo Costa, Dennis Pearson over there in Boston, the girl wanted to shake those titties, water boxer, and my main man Jordan Lee, who came out for the fucking This Is Not Happening Again. Here we go, Ari Shaffir. It's time to see the devil, cocksucker. Oh yeah, here we go. Oh shit. Oh shit. You bad motherfucker. Columbus Day. I don't know what the fuck's going on here.
Oh. Nice.
Put the light back on. You were all right. Oh my God.
A Metallica moment.
That was a nice Metallica moment. What do you think? Would she order cheeseburgers?
Sure.
How many cheeseburgers could you eat right now, Lisa?
I don't know.
You want to eat another star?
Sure.
I know you do. Look at him.
Sure.
You got him hooked.
He don't give a fuck, Lisa. Yeah. We're already down to like 500 milligrams.
How much do you eat a day, Lee, of just those?
Milligrams. What do you mean most? As much as I can?
If you ate three more, it would just burn through. Even if you ate two and three more, this burns right through.
Bro, I have like...
You don't even feel it. You don't even feel
like the two I have, I don't even feel. This is the acid.
You don't feel it. This is everything gets overpowered.
Because he gives me fucking.
I'm telling you, I'll give you two more. It'll burn right through it. This is what you need in an hour to take you off the jet. Put on David Bowie, Ground Control to Major Tom.
Ground Control.
Let's do this motherfucker right now and shit. If we're going to go deep, let's go deep into. Eddie, you want to start?
Oh, no.
How are you going to come up with a twist?
Play that song.
Fucking flipping through
song.
The air. I mean,
yeah, I'm good.
You want another start, dog? It's time. Yes. One more. To tame the animal. Look at you.
What animal?
The animal inside of you. Look at you. You're a fucking savage. Ground control to Major Tom. 6, 5.
Yeah, that's a whole crazy beginning part, too, right?
No, it's fucking craziness, man.
10 seconds.
10 seconds. Oh. What time? It's still fucking early.
Yeah, bro.
Hey, man.
2:15 in the afternoon.
You could still go out. You could still go out and fucking do what you're doing. I appreciate you guys sitting in. We're just three fucking morons talking shit on a Sunday night. What else are you gonna do?
What is it?
This is as good as it gets for you.
You guys doing shows on Sunday nights now? Is that the thing?
No. Just tonight. It's Columbus Day tomorrow. There's no work. What the fuck?
Okay.
People at home, they can't fucking sleep. They're sitting there with the thumb up their ass.
Oh yeah.
You know, you just gotta sit around. This is it.
Joey Diaz.
Oh shit. What are you creeping me out for, Eddie Bob? I thought it was the person I was looking at on Twitter and shit. That was whispering. Put your helmet on, cocksucker. We're going deep tonight. Oh. What's the story? We're going to eat this other half of one, Ari Shaffir.
No.
We're going deep. We're not going out.
That's the start.
When you what?
That's the worst start.
You who?
I'm good. I'm high. I'm fucking good.
Me too. Everything's good.
Put your helmet on.
Ground control. Who is that? Who sings that song?
David Bowie.
Where the fuck you been? Put it back on, Lee. Where are you silencing? He's about to go off. Put it on from the beginning.
Be with you.
This is.
Really? Oh no!
No, Joey.
Ain't the toughest man. The last real juice. So ladies. We don't fuck around. We go deep here.
Wow. What?
There's people in other countries that are wishing they had a star.
Playing for Enterprises.
And we're sitting here fucking.
He did that star like Mad Max ate the salamander. Yeah. Death's trying to get out of his mouth. And he's like. He's sucking it down. Too little.
That star was delicious. They're really delicious. You sure you don't want another one? Good. This will take the edge, Joe. You ready for half of one of these, bro?
Half of what? No. I'm good, man. I'm good. Thank you, though. Appreciate it.
My fucking ear swelling is going down a little bit.
Where'd you have ear swelling from? The pool?
I fucking told you from jumping, and it's even hot right now. It's fucking on fire.
Really?
Last night, I took one of those 4-year-old Vikings, and I fell asleep like a baby. Tonight, what are you eating over there, Lee? You're still eating that fucking salamander?
It's not even whether or not he wants to go down with it. Try to spit it back.
We don't give a fuck no more.
Oh my god.
Lee's a soldier.
I don't have a choice. It just takes the arguments away.
What do you think this is? Communist Castro here? You got choices.
Yeah, bro, it takes like 30 minutes if I wanted to say no, and then I feel bad, and then they go on Twitter.
What do you say?
He said give more stars.
He said give more stars. That's what he said.
Where's ground control to Major Tom? What
happened?
Ground control to
What happened to Major Tom?
What was that about?
What?
That song.
Put it on from the beginning. We'll break it down here.
It's got to be about drugs.
Go ahead, Lee. Put it on.
Space is always used as the taking drugs? Off and blasting off. Isn't it always used as a metaphor
for
drugs?
Yeah, probably, right? Which ones?
It could be about, you know what? It might be about nothing. There's some singers that write about nothing. They're just putting cool phrases together. It's really about nothing. And I think David Bowie might be one of those guys.
No way. Really?
Sometimes.
What?
I think.
Just like, didn't even mean anything?
Yeah. There's bands out there.
We're going to talk over.
A bunch of cool
go ahead, keep up.
It's not really about anything.
Up.
And they do it on purpose.
To fuck with their audience? Songs.
No, just to show you that it's all about the melody. It's not what you say, really. That's the icing on the cake.
Like that R.E.M. song? Really, like that R.E.M. song?
I don't know about R.E.M. I don't know.
No, you know the one where it's like...
What's R.E.M. got to do with this conversation?
Do you know which one?
Eddie, talking to like...
Stairway to Heaven. That's
yeah.
You like that song, right?
Yeah.
What's it about?
So you're saying that was just about nothing? That's them just saying.
No, Eddie Bravo, get in the mic.
The melody.
No, it could be about something, but you don't know what it's about.
I don't know what it's about.
No one knows it's
about. No, I hear what you're saying.
But people love it because of the melodies.
Yeah.
It's not really if the words are making sense. Just the lines sound cool, and within the line, does it make sense? It doesn't. There's really no. I mean, there's no story to it. There's a lot of songs like that. You just name. I know. 80% of the songs.
Fire. That's the R.E.M. song. We didn't start the fire.
What is that about?
I know nothing. Exactly. That's what I'm saying. Nothing. He's just saying some stuff.
Who?
Exactly. He's just rhyming some stuff. And he's like, right?
That's cool.
Right.
Oh, I love those lyrics. I love them. And he goes, meanwhile,
they're not about anything.
They're just a stream of consciousness.
Who's playing the maracas? You hear the maracas? Is it me?
It happens a lot.
Oh.
You understand that it's.
And then you give them more power when you're a little fucking 14-year-old?
You let them relate those phrases to their lives. And that's supposedly, you know, in the music business, I think. It's better that your audience doesn't know exactly what you're singing about. That's actually better.
Oh,
so that they can kind of just make up their own shit. And then, you know, once you tell them the truth and they've grown up thinking a certain way about the song, it's actually, how about lyrics that you thought they were saying, you find out they weren't saying that at all?
Yeah.
And that was a cool line that you gave them credit for the lyrics, and it turns out it's a whole different line. You know, so.
We can miss my friend.
All that means is about the vocal melody. It's not
they just
totally
get people involved
the lyrics.
In
the lyrics are extra. If the lyrics are great too, then that's a bonus. But you don't have to know what
who's
the song is.
How many songs are like that?
Think about all your songs and try to figure out if you really, really know what that song's about.
How about the one with the, it's about baptism or whatever?
I love that song, Cherub Rock by Smashing Pumpkins.
What song is that?
I have no idea what it's about.
It's
I love
Cherub
Disarm.
Rock.
I don't know what Disarm's about. I love that song. Tonight, I really don't know what...
It's about tonight. What the fuck? It's tonight. Yeah. Can't be about tomorrow.
That's a good point.
Today.
It's about tonight.
It's about today.
Yeah, I don't know what those songs are about.
You don't. If you stop to think about it, most of the songs you love, you don't know what the fuck they're
about.
What?
That's what makes them interesting.
You don't know what they're about.
But
really.
Judas Priest sang. He was singing...
I thought he was singing to the devil or something, at least.
No, he wasn't singing to the devil. He was singing to cock.
What?
Same devil, just a different fucking outfit.
Name a couple of your favorite songs. Any of them. Just the songs that you like. Just any song.
That Led Zeppelin song where they go,
You know what that song is about?
No.
Of course not.
We come from a land of the ice.
Is that one of your favorite songs?
Yes.
Okay, give me another one of your favorite songs. Give me another one. Give me name one of your favorite songs. Name one of your favorite songs. I'm like a magician. I bet you don't know. Most people think they know.
It's not a made up thing.
Yeah, most people think they don't realize that they don't know what these songs are about.
What?
Some of them, yes.
Some of them, if you're obsessed with the band, you listen to interviews and they ask, what's the song about? And then they might say in the interview, what the song is about this and that. Those songs, there are songs out there, but you got to hear it from the songwriter in an interview. If you don't hear it from him, like maybe live, that guy will introduce a song and say, this song's about my sister and, you know, how hard it was growing up with no parents. You know, then you go, okay, then you remember that shit. Okay, that's that one song. But if you didn't hear him talk about it, you would never know what the song's
about.
It's
like when you go in a hotel and some dude goes up there playing song. This is about a song I wrote when my mama was in the hospital. Who gives a fuck?
Just sing. Play it, that's all.
Yeah. You get don't ruin it for me.
You get 200 a night. Just fucking play, yeah, cocksucker.
Play the melody.
Lenny Kravitz once said that he doesn't, or was it, no, I think it was Seal. Seal said he doesn't want people. He doesn't want to explain. Seal. Hey, Seal's a talented motherfucker.
Fuck Seal.
Come on, Seal's talented.
Fuck Seal.
Come on.
I mean, Kravitz, I would have listened to him. Hey,
fuck Seal. Just wants his ass off. He had some good shit. Crazy, wait, song
Seal.
Crazy.
Oh, yeah, Crazy. The one that's so annoying.
Yeah, but he sings it to everybody.
Okay, the Batman song. The Batman song.
He's still showing up singing that fucking song on Ellen.
The Batman song sucks. But on that album, that was good shit. He had some good fucking shit. For pop, I'd way rather listen to Seal first two Seal albums than like the shit that's out now. You know, like when, like.
Did you get this from fucking doctor yet? They want you to shit an envelope. Did you get this from SAG yet? Any problem? This one, you know, you got problems.
Why did you bring this into the office?
Because I just remembered. This is what I got to do with my life. This is what my life.
Somebody puts his gummies.
Huh?
Why don't we talk about lyrics?
Sample deposit, right here, yeah.
How do we get on that?
I don't know. I'm just trying to tell you people that this is what happens sometimes. This is what you get in the mail now from SAG. UCLA Burley Pathology.
Yeah.
All right? They'll just send you this when you're 45 and they say you got to shit in one of these.
What do you mean? What do you mean?
Right here. You got to shit in this little fucking paper.
Is that for SAG?
Yeah, this is some SAG. Yeah, the shit.
Wait, what?
You think I'm fucking with you guys here?
What is that for?
I'm trying to drop knowledge on you motherfuckers. When you turn a certain age, you got to shit in the glass. The first time. And you have to send it to a doctor. They pay this guy like 12 an hour to analyze your shit. Jose Diaz, see? I got to send this in. I got to shit.
What? Hold on. They send you?
Yeah.
Stuff at home?
I didn't shit in it yet.
Your shit's way bigger than that.
What? And you're supposed to shit in here and send it back to them?
When you turn a certain age, you're going to get a call one day.
What do you mean?
You
just send us stuff?
Be careful what kind of shit you put in there. Make sure it's some good, healthy shit.
Who you think you're
dealing with? Who are you sending stuff
to? I'm going to eat some fucking good Chinese food, some salads. I'm going to fuck them up. All right, you get a call from Kaiser Permanente saying, Ari Shaffir, here's the deal. You got to fucking pontificate. What's another word for shit? What's the decent word for shit? Pontificate or something like that? You got to do something.
Defecate
and send it to us. You're like, what are you talking? I thought it was a joke.
No way.
And they sent me this, and my wife is like, get that in the mail. You got to shit in a cup.
What do you mean? They can't collect your fecal matter.
And they tell you what's going on with you if you're half a Martian.
What?
What kind of vegetables you're eating?
They're processing you.
Does Brad Pitt have to do that?
No, what is this?
Everybody does this.
What is this?
Have you heard of this? No.
Pathology outreach services, everybody.
I think you might have got gypped.
No, the prison psychiatrist told me I was going to get this in the mail.
Wait.
Fucking.
Wait.
Oh, collect stool for sample collections instruction. Read that out loud. You think
someone
I'm fucking
print
with
that
you?
Up?
And print that up. I love you guys too much. Someday when you guys get old, you're going to see that they send you this shit.
No, wait. Is this because of prison or is this because?
No, it's because of fucking just being old. That's what you got to start doing when you turn fucking 40.
Wrap sampling bottle.
Look at this. I'm getting emails on a Sunday night. Weezer music video.
It's a plastic bag.
I told you. I ain't fucking lying to you. Read that out loud. Read that out loud. Humiliation when you get old and shit.
He's just laughing at you.
What?
They mail you at home to disturb you.
They bother you.
Collect your shit.
They give you this.
Are you going to shit in that?
You have to. You got no choice. They'll bother you till you shit in that fucking thing. They will call you every day.
Do it on the podcast.
No, I'm not going to shit that thing on the podcast.
Why not?
Because. I ate a
imagine
Cuban sandwich.
The ratings.
No, I ate a Cuban sandwich for dinner.
Come on, you got to shit on the podcast.
Who wants to smoke a joint? I got another
joint.
Who
wants your shit?
The fucking UCLA. How many times I got to tell you? OC Auto Package. When you turn fucking 45, you got to shit in the package, answering your questions about correct the call.
How do they know it's your shit?
Because
what if you put like a 20-year-old shit in there?
All right. What are the risk factors for colorectal cancer? Age, people with inflammatory bowel disease, or Crohn's disease? A personal history of colorectal cancer. Or
they're going to make you videotape it.
What happened?
With no edits, no cuts.
What is the colorectal cancer? I don't know what the fuck
the
they're saying in here.
These
people send you to skate. You know, one minute you're walking down the street, you're smoking a joint.
For the mail, Joey. That's some sort of weird scam.
What mail? No, this is fucking sad. I got a call.
That could be a joke. This could be.
Guys, I ain't fucking with you.
They can't collect your...
I'm saying someone's probably fucking with you.
They collect your fecal matters. Who does?
SAG insurance.
The insurance takes your shit?
Yes.
How do they know it's your shit?
Well, what I'm going to do is I'm going to go to the park and put a dog shit in there. Fuck with their mind. I don't know.
Yeah, exactly. Put a horse shit in there.
When you go to the doctor and he puts his finger up your ass, they take the scrapings and they send that to the sample, too.
Oh.
You got a finger up your ass.
To who do they send it to?
They send it to some guy.
You can tell a lot about
the research. Like $15 an hour, and he checks.
That's not enough.
And every 5 years, listen. When you turn 50, you got to go for a colonoscopy.
What?
You got to drink a milkshake, pee for 16 hours, and they shove a camera up your fucking ass.
So that's coming for all of us.
That's for everybody. It's got to go.
We all walk.
A third of us are gonna get that Terry Bradshaw disease.
What, retarded?
No.
Which one?
The one with the skin falls off.
Terry Bradshaw, skin's falling off?
Yeah. One of those leprosy. Guys. Joe Namath. Joe Namath and Terry Bradshaw.
That's leprosy.
No. No. It's like leprosy, though.
Is that still around, leprosy?
I don't fucking
know. That's the worst fucking disease.
I don't know.
No one can even help you.
Look up the scar.
Yeah.
I'm hungry, but I don't want to eat these stars.
That's one vaccine.
That's what happens. I usually get so high, I just eat one. You got Pringles?
No, I'm saying, instead of just collecting stars in your place, get some Pringles once in a while.
What fucking
get something
Pringles?
Non-medicated to eat.
Look at the size of me. I need Pringles in my fucking life, cocksucker. I need Pringles in my life. Why are you insulting me, man? What's up, Eddie? Probably.
We can pause it and go.
What pause? There's no pauses in real life. What are you doing?
There's no pauses in real life.
There's no pauses in real life. We ain't fucking around here. We ain't editing podcasts.
No, I thought you wanted to smoke a joint.
We'll smoke it. We'll figure it out. We'll go out there.
That's a T-shirt right there.
Communist. What's up? You want another piece of this shit or what?
No.
You good?
Yes.
Oh my God, look at the shape of Ari. Holy shit.
It was really strong. Huh? It's strong as fuck.
Let's periscope this shit, Ari.
No, I'm just having a good time.
Me too. Oh my God. I don't even want to look at my eyeballs. I'm scared. I don't want to talk to nobody. I just want to sit here and look around the room. Any problem? Happy you came down for
it. Hey, anytime. I love it, man. And, you know, I just want to tell you that most of the 10th Planet Association worships you. They love you.
Oh, I love them too.
The 10WO, everybody on the 10WO loves you.
I love them too. I love
everything. There's got to be 10th Planet fans still showing up to all your
shows. All the shows.
All of them, right?
All the shows. Yeah, you see a 10th Planet shirt and it does something to you. You see a lot of guys that come and go, I don't want to take your time.
It's some new, like, I'm like, oh, that's cool.
Yeah, they really are. It's...
Every school designs their own rash guards. And I got like 55 or something like that, and they're
different
all
schools?
Competing on designs.
What's
the
story? You gonna turn the air conditioning on? Are you gonna have
I benefit because I don't think anybody has as many cool rash guards as I do. I have a shit load of badass rash guards for my schools.
Really?
But I have nothing to do. I'll rip off a little part of that design here. I'll rip off a little part of that design here.
Cool.
A little of that. Make my own. You know, it's a trade-off. They're using the logo. I'm using their designs.
And jiu-jitsu is rolling right along, man.
Yep. I got, like I said, 55 schools. If you're interested in jiu-jitsu, get on 10planetjj.com. Click locations. You might be surprised to find a location near you. Most of my locations are in small towns.
Now.
Small towns.
55?
Something like that. I'm not sure. Could be 51. Could be 59. Could
From
be...
From one.
Yeah.
This is what Duncan sends me. He's watching.
Oh shit. Let me see that. Let me see that.
What's going on with that?
Oh shit.
That's a dude, right?
I can't see because my glasses are on.
He's naked. He's got a big mouth.
Are you allowed to put that on the camera?
He's shaped like Bobby Lee.
Oh my God.
What is that?
Oh my God, please help me.
What was that?
Look at
that was it.
The fucking award of the night goes to Duncan Trussell. Nobody sends nobody this unless they're a professional. Oh my God. Duncan, you suck dick. Oh my God.
Oh my God.
You have to watch this from the beginning.
What is that monkey thing?
I don't fucking know what it is.
Oh, man.
Oh.
Man.
Oh, God, 20 seconds.
Oh.
Okay.
It's like some kind of monkey thing.
Oh, my God.
That's so weird.
No, he's
only
like
Duncan so would fucking
he's
find
like a Ukrainian man in his. Oh, he's naked.
Text number. Text Duncan.
The Joey, look at the camera.
What's up, cocksuckers?
Look at the camera.
Text Duncan the number to call in. All right, text number.
Is this him?
Wait, don't say the number.
I'm not going to.
Cocksucker. That's him who texted me that video.
Okay.
Send him the number so he can call in. Tell him to call in 2 minutes.
Okay.
We got to discuss where he got this video. Who sent him this video. And why he would send me that video if he knew the condition I was in.
He really got down on it.
Oh, my fucking God. You text him?
Not yet. I have to get...
He looked like a hedgehog. He's looking like God. A hedgehog, the way he was hunched over.
I'm loving this, people. I haven't done this
the times. Of muff hair he has.
This is as crazy hair. As I like for it to get in my world. I'm controlled. I'm around friends.
Wait, that was a lot of muff hair, though, right?
No.
That was the creepiest fucking thing I ever saw in my life. Only Duncan could find that. I didn't know what it was. I thought it was some guy singing. I thought it was Duncan making a video of himself saying, like, whoa.
I'm just testing it. Keep going.
Texting what?
I'm testing it.
Oh, my God.
Are you sending it to him so that he can put it on the screen?
I don't know.
Are we allowed to? Are you allowed to?
It's a YouTube video, I guess.
But he's naked. It's on YouTube. No way it's YouTube.
That's naked? Who is it? Who
that
is
can't
that?
Be you. He was naked, right?
Well, who is it? Where did the video come from? Who has the video? Where is? What is it? What do you mean?
What the fuck? Put the video on. Let's see the video on the big screen.
I can't. It's on your phone.
Well, you can send it to yourself. You know all these computer fucking tricks.
Okay, let me try, but hold on.
Here, text Duncan. Tell
I'm
him
to text him. Hold on.
Tell him to call in the number.
Oh,
FCC's going to come after you for putting this up on.
For doing what?
For putting this up online.
I'm not going to put it up online. It's not me. It's some fucking little kid dancing around with a bush. That's got nothing to do
he
with it.
He looks like a monkey, that kid. What is
oh,
it?
My God. That's the scariest thing ever. I didn't know what it was. Like, I thought it was Duncan trying to put a flashlight in front of his face, trying to go, ooh. Boy, was I in fucking shock. Lee, what are you doing?
Son?
One day, beards on your genitalia are going to be back.
Beards,
one day
that's going
to be. One of these days, girls are going to be attracted to that again.
Just a mop of hair.
The hairiest bush ever.
Somebody has to be now, right? There's got to be a percentage.
Beards are in. Beards are in. They're officially in. High school kids have beards now.
I've never cut my ball hair. I mean, I've done it like 15 times in my life.
You
what?
Cut my ball hair.
Cut your bald hair?
Bald hair.
That is the funniest
cut your
fucking
bald
thing.
Hair.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
I have ever seen.
Do you?
Yeah, I trimmed that shit.
Yeah.
Fuck, I'm a hairy man.
All right, really? Duncan's on the line, ladies and gentlemen.
I trimmed the shit out of my shit.
All right, Duncan's on the line.
I'm like half Armenian,
hey,
half
up,
Iranian.
Guy?
Duncan, what the fuck is that video? Who is that?
Nobody knows, man. Nobody knows.
Oh, my God.
Can you tweet it out so people can see?
Oh.
That comes from that actually comes from Brendan Walsh. He's got a friend named Laser Wang that sends him that stuff every day. Like the creepiest, weirdest shit.
That didn't even look like a person. What was that? That looked like a thing, a fucking hedgehog.
That's a person for sure. That's just some little guy alone in his apartment dancing for someone. Too bad you can't show it.
That is fucking... we almost died.
Show it.
Well, let's try to.
We're
going
to go to
jail.
It's so weird looking.
We'll do 20 fucking...
Oh, yeah, there's naked guys.
Yeah, no, you can't be doing that shit. these people.
I'm sorry I sent it to you. You know, I know what's going on, and I just felt like God wanted me to send that to you.
I think it's disgusting, man.
I can't even focus in on what video site he's on.
What was that music? That's it. Oh, that's my fair.
This is just.
He's really kicking it up.
America, this is really fucking bad. This is bad to think that people do this.
You guys should stare at your money. That's another thing I like to do when I'm out.
What the fuck? You should have came down here, I'm telling you. Right now, you would have been the ringleader of this fucking acid trip here.
You stare at a dollar bill. It's so weird.
All right, who's got a dollar bill? Let's put it to a test. I got no dollar bills. I know Lee's got a dollar bill. Do you have to turn the lights off or say some hymns or anything?
No, just look at it.
All right.
Look at it with the veil of conditioning lifted. It's fucking weird. I mean, I would stare. I remember doing that once. Me and my friend actually, like, burnt money once, like, old school hippies.
Really?
Just because we were staring at it, and it seemed so, I don't know, just so malevolent.
You know me, Doug.
Yeah, to burn money, it's so fucking bad.
Yeah, it's like the ultimate blasphemy, but it's meaningless because it's just a rectangle of paper, but it's when you're doing it, it's illegal, too, I think, but when you're doing it, it's really fascinating to notice how your brain reacts to just burning paper.
Huh. It's very interesting. What else is going on, my brother?
Well, I don't know, man. I've been watching your podcast, really enjoying it. You guys seem to be having a great time. And I just wanted to call in and say hello. I wish I had something interesting to report.
Dog, that fucking thing that you sent was enough. You threw us for a fucking loop. That thing, that's wanted in 20 states, that little dance from that fucking poor little Mexican guy.
It's so fucking hilarious. I'll send you some more stuff, man.
No, not tonight. Not tonight. Any other night but tonight. My mind is overloaded already with that poor bastard singing with a bush. I love you, D.
I love you guys.
Thank you for calling in, brother. You got it. What's up, Ari Shaffir? How long are you going to look at that dollar bill now? For an hour?
I don't know.
Jesus.
Anything? Maybe money was meant to be looked at on acid.
Yeah, maybe.
That's an old one.
What's that?
An old dollar bill.
What difference does it make?
You think I don't know.
It's got a fucking, what's, you got a new one on you?
No.
Oh, look at it. Ari's not even going to give you the old one.
That's fine.
What's the matter?
You think you get that dollar back? You don't never met me.
What's the matter, Lee? You all right?
I'm cool.
You want another star to calm you down?
Sure.
No. He's a savage and shit. A nation of fucking set. What's up, EB? You're sitting there. You got the new haircut. You don't want to say nothing.
I'll be hanging out, man.
When is Eddie Bravo Radio coming back? We're coming back as a new fucking label.
It'll come back eventually. It's just, man, there's been so much shit going on in my life. You know, it's needed to take a little break from it.
It gets busy. Sunday nights is a bad night for me, too. It's family night. In, you're relaxing. Now I gotta get up at 9 o'clock and go talk shit for 2 fucking hours. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I love it when you're doing this shit.
But I have put out a couple songs on my SoundCloud lately. Last week, I put out an old song by Temple of Mir. It was never released. It was a song that I never put out there. But I always wanted to finish it. And Billy Howard from A Perfect Circle, he engineered it. And we took all her old vocals and redid the drums, the bass, a lot of the strings, left a lot of the guitar that from the original, and just popped it on SoundCloud.com/Eddie-Bravo. If you liked any of that old Temple of Mir stuff, you'll dig this one. It's in the same vein. I think it's better than all that other stuff, especially now with the high-quality production. It's now this is the way Temple of Mir was supposed to sound, just like this.
It's better than you.
It's better than you.
See, where's that Cuban sandwich, cocksucker?
In the car. It's gone.
Fuck it. You leave it in the car. It smells like onion.
You brought me over there and you gave it to me there.
Anginu. That's what Italian people say. Anginu.
What's anginu?
I don't know.
Agita.
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 What does that mean?
Heartburn.
Oh.
What do the Jews call it?
know.
They got something. What do they call heartburn when they get agitated? Fucking Jews get agitated. They call
heartburn?
It something.
Give me, I don't know.
It's called a burp. What's going on, Lee? You starting to see elephants?
Sure.
You ready to smoke another number?
They'll calm me down?
Huh?
That'll calm it down?
Sure, that'll calm the dragon down for a little while. He's going to show up at your door breathing again in 2 hours. What's up, Ari? Everybody's depressed and everybody's pooped out. That's it?
No, I'm all right. You got any new moves and stuff?
New moves?
Yeah.
Can you show Lee a move tonight? Show Lee.
What's your biggest
fucking move?
How far is it going now?
It's always evolving, right?
Yeah.
It's always changing. It's just like asking a comedian, do you have new material?
What are the trends now? Like,
we got into leg locks heavy.
Really?
10th Planet has always been leg lock friendly. I just didn't want to be heavy on heel hooks. Like, that's our main goal, is to fuck you up with legs. Yeah. I never wanted to go that route because in MMA, it's risky in MMA. It's great when there's no punches. It's awesome. But now with the rise of the submission-only game and that, man, you got to have your leg locks together if you're going to mess with any submission-only tournaments.
Why? Because they just keep trying to get
the legs. The legs are a very big part of submission-only.
Yeah.
And not a big part of traditional points tournaments. So submission-only is blowing the fuck up. There's all these tournaments busting up everywhere. People.
Submission-only. That's it.
No points. No points.
Well, yeah, what are we talking about?
Chokes. That's it.
Yeah. I like that.
So you asked the question, what's the latest evolution? Over the last 6 months, leg locks.
Okay.
Getting really, really heavy with leg locks. Just as heavy as rubber guard, just as heavy as all the lockdown stuff, as heavy as all the twister stuff. That heavy. We're taking it to the next level. And it used to be a 10 plant. We always had heel hook guys. We always had guys that were all into heel hooks. And even though personally I wasn't going to make the heel hook game my number one priority, it was always my backup game. When my clinching game wasn't working. But
you always call those other guys in too. Like Shigeki and stuff, you'd be like, hey, show this.
Exactly,
show this. You're good at it.
We always had a few leg lock guys in the mix. There's always a few. Shigeki was the original guy who was getting the inside heel hooks from the saddle on. But now everybody in the system from day one, the white belts, they're all exposed, heavily exposed to the heel hook system. Yeah. So that's the biggest change. And it's changed my game tremendously. Sometimes I just go after heel hooks the whole time. I never did that before.
Really?
And now I'm just going after them. And if you're really good at rubber guard, that means your flexibility is on point and your dexterity is also, it's got to be solid. So that's exactly what's needed for leg locks. You need dexterity in your legs, the flexibility to get in and out and interweave. They need to work like arms. So rubber guard and heel hooks go together so well. Nathan Orchard, he's all rubber guard. Hooks, and he's got other stuff too, but he's very strong with just those two. And same thing with Brian Debs. He's one of my purple belts from he's the head instructor at 10th Planet Beaumont, Texas. He's all rubber guard and heel hooks. It works so well.
Getting closer, Eddie. Getting closer.
When people pull out of your rubber guard, if they posture out, it fails. Bam! You got a good leg lock game. It's right there. Boom! You can't clinch for the rubber guard. Start attacking the legs then, or go after them right away. That's the biggest change in the 10th Planet game is. Now we're all heavy with it. Now it's standard. It's in the we have heel hooks in the warm up curriculum.
Really?
Yeah, I have white belts that are really good at heel hooks already.
Yeah.
That's the biggest change lately.
Now they legal or not legal in competition?
In points, in some tournaments they're not legal. On the big ones, the IBJJF, like the big ones, the traditional ones, heel hooks are illegal. You can't even reap. You can't even bring your outside leg in, and you get disqualified. It's really
why? Because it's so easy to get injured.
That's what they say, but it's really not.
Which is the one to tap, you're already injured? Is that the one?
That's what they say.
That when you tap, you're already injured.
That's all bullshit. That's all bullshit. It's like your shoulder is just as vulnerable as your knee. You get put in Kimuras and Americanas, that shit cranks the shit out of your shoulders. Can tear shoulders apart. What's better or worse? Your shoulder getting torn off or your ACL getting torn off? It's both the same thing. Why are we protecting the sacred knees? Oh, they're so sacred. It's all sacred. But you know what? This is jiu-jitsu, and it turns out that heel hooks aren't that dangerous. We've always allowed reaping at 10-1. I never discourage reaping.
What's reaping?
Always. No, it's rare that someone gets hurt from a heel hook in or a toe.
What's reaping?
Bringing the outside leg in. It's a your legs, there's all these different leg configurations when attacking legs. There's inside heel hooks, outside heel hooks, and all different kinds of variations and all different ways you can place your legs. And some places are the best place for your legs and some are not so good but still effective. And there's all these different levels and positions. Reaping is just one position where the outside leg comes in and over the hip and it seems like, oh, it's going to tear the knee apart, but it doesn't. It doesn't. People rarely get hurt from heel hooks. Abu Dhabi allows heel hooks, and that's the, as far as no gi goes, that's the most prestigious. So they allow all sorts of heel hooks, and you know, sometimes people get hurt, but you know, you can get hurt with neck cranks and elbows and shoulders. So I think leg locks just got a real bad rap, and it was from the Brazilian jiu-jitsu community. And I think that, you know, the grappling systems that had nothing to do with Brazilian jiu-jitsu, like catch wrestling and even judo and there was sambo. These styles were rich in leg locks, so that was that was huge in battling these guys. The Brazilian jiu-jitsu guys, they knew that the only shot they had was leg locks. So that's the, it seems like instead of embracing the leg locks, like, let's just make it illegal and let's just cut it out. It just seemed
really?
Yeah, like they don't have to deal with it now. They don't have to deal with it. We just made it illegal. Boom. It should be legal. It really should. Naga has, they allow heel hooks. There's not this epidemic of people with torn ACLs. It's just not happening. You tear your, I've never had my ACL tore from heel hooks. I've been doing jiu-jitsu 21. Yeah, it could happen. Anything can happen. You can get hurt. People have gotten hurt. People have gotten hurt from various positions. You know, you just part of the game. You know, it's like playing basketball or playing football. Sometimes you're going to tweak your knee. Sometimes you're going to tweak your elbow, your shoulder. You might break a finger or something. It's just part of sports. People get hurt playing basketball all the goddamn time. They tear their knee apart in wrestling and all that. So it's jiu-jitsu. You don't get hurt more than any other sport. It's the same. I've been there in the trenches for 21 years.
It's funny. I went to dinner with some friends of mine. They have kids that are old, you know, like 14, 15-year-old kids. And they were talking about girls' soccer, how the one kid's daughter has had 3 concussions already. That they don't fuck around in New Jersey with
what?
That soccer.
Concussions.
Concussions, playing fucking soccer, bumping into other fucking people.
Yep.
I've never heard of a society that got so many fucking concussions. When I was a kid, I had one concussion. I fell off a motherfucking XL-175 doing 80 on some Sea Caucus road with them. It wasn't developed. I used to be a motorcycle guy. Did you know that, bro?
No.
A lot of people don't. When I first moved to North Bergen.
Why do you think it's misconception that's happening?
It's
about
the
you?
Weirdest thing. When I first moved to North Bergen, those guys, the guys I ran with, were motorcycle kids. So we all had. We all had a.
Oh, that kind of motorcycle?
Kawasaki 250?
No. Rockets? I started with a Honda 50.
Wait, were you up in the air?
I started from the bottom, dog. I started
like,
from the bottom
like,
to the
legs
top.
Out of the air, jumping?
No.
My first car was a moped. I had a moped when I was 15 when I got my. It's like the learner's permit thing. You can drive mopeds. Dude, I was known as the long-haired dude
in
with
Southern
a moped.
California?
You know how many people pulled up next to me like, dudes, thought I was a chick from behind? It's like, I had this hair, I had the shades. I'm 15 years old, sitting like a little girl. Dudes would pull
so
up.
So proud
go,
of yourself.
Oh, shit. They'd always they'd look at me and go, oh, shit. It's like, oh, shit.
Fuck mopeds. No, when I first moved to Jersey, I had a Honda used to make a 50 that was an automatic.
What do you mean automatic?
No clutch.
Oh.
Just 3 on the tree. Bang, bang, bang.
Yeah.
And there were 50 cc's, a Honda Mini Trail. And it just so happened that you could steal them off the trucks in Sea Caucus, so the whole neighborhood had a Honda Mini Trail. But then, you know what? You could borrow out a 50 cc engine. Like if you have one of those geeky kids in the neighborhood instead of jiu-jitsu, they bought out engines. You get it to be 75 cc. But by that time, it was too late. Yamaha had like an XL-75, a Kawasaki that was brilliant. Yeah. XR-80, that's what it was. An XR, fuck the 75. We're showing up with an 80, bitch. And it came with the fucking already ready to go with the mud flaps and shit. Yeah. That wasn't good enough. Then you got a 125. Then after the 125, you get a 175. The one after that is 250. The one after that, you're just a fucking biker. I stopped at 175. But, bro, I had every type of motorcycle growing up. Like, I loved all that dumb shit. But the one I loved the most was the lawnmower ones. Nobody ever had a lawnmower motorcycle.
Lawnmower motorcycle?
It's a lawnmower engine. Yeah, yes, those Mexicans mini bikes. Invented the fucking thing. Yeah, mini bikes. Yes. Mexicans invented the lawnmower mini bike. Where are you going? Ari, oh. Where the fuck are you going?
I just want to go down on the ground for a minute.
No, you can't lay down. You can't lay down.
Gonna... I can give you a different mic.
Yeah, give me a different mic. Go ahead, but keep talking about the lawnmower.
Leave him alone. He'll be fine.
You know what's crazy about my moped that still haunts me in my nightmares? I swear, it haunts me.
Wait, Eddie, I can already just switch.
My,
Just switch seats.
No, you can't. Right. Who's going to fucking switch seats now? He's on the floor. What do you think this is? Musical fucking games?
So, you know, on a moped, there's no gas reader. What do you call it? Gas odometers? You just have to kind of guess because you have to mix. you have to make the gas. You take this moped. You have to mix it. Yeah, it's a weird
fuck
moped.
That. No, I'm telling you.
So you had to guess. I had to keep track of the miles.
You have
to
pedal and shit.
Dude, if you run out of gas, it's like a bike.
What?
Yes, mopeds were half bike, half motorcycle.
You have legs of strength. What the fuck,
dude,
you?
Dude, you have to do this to go like.
It wasn't worth the aggravation.
You barely go inch long.
That was like the terrible. Biggest fucking farce the Americans had. It always ran out of fucking oil. You had to make oil.
So I dream that I'm on my moped, and I'm like, fuck. I don't know when the last time I don't know if I'm going to run out of gas. It's been so long, I can't remember when I put fuel in it last. And I have these nightmares.
Have a dream.
And then I wake up. Whoa. Always stressful dreams. I'm on my moped, and I can't remember. But
what?
But that's one of those dreams that if there was a gas odometer and that wasn't stressful, maybe that would have been a good dream about, dude, I had a great dream. I was on my moped. I was 15. But since there was that drama there, maybe that's what fucked up the good dream. Because now I got all stressed out about it, right? But if I didn't get stressed out about it, maybe I would just have a cool moped dream.
All right.
Does that make sense?
Yeah, a little bit.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Because check this out. One of the craziest nightmares I always have. I have this one all the time.
So if you don't get stressed, you just have a good moped. A moped fantasy.
What the fuck? That's what I'm thinking.
Lee, what the fuck is that? What is this?
In your life,
because of the gas.
And then stress is the gas.
I'm like, I don't remember the last time I put gas in this thing. I could run out at any second.
Oh yeah.
And then I'm all stressed out.
That's
I wake up sweating.
That's the stress of your life.
Yeah.
Coming through your horrible dream.
You think so? It's more that?
Okay. Maybe that. No, you say that. Because I think that's right.
I don't know. I think that's supposed to... Like, I think I'm getting a treat. I'm getting a cool moped dream. But the fact that the gas... That thing didn't exist. The gas odometer. It stresses me out. Yeah. Just like when I used to work at a strip club.
Yeah.
I think I'm supposed to... I always have nightmares that I'm at the strip club DJing and I can't remember any of the girls' names or I can't find any of the CDs. You got to be on. You got to know the girls. You got to know their songs. You got to know every girl's different. There's a girl that likes Tool and Marilyn Manson. There's a techno girl. There's an R&B chick. There's a hip-hop chick. There's a chick that just says... Just play anything, and then you just play your favorite shit. You got every chick, you have songs attached to them. Your mind's got to be sharp to be a strip club DJ. It ain't easy.
How do you remember all this?
Hold on.
Strip club DJ wannabe. Listen to this right now.
This is how to be a fucking... This is this. Wow. I've had professional DJs come in to audition that were sweating because there's no way he's going to be able to figure this out. He doesn't know the girls. Whoa. And you got 2.5 minute songs. You got to keep it going. You got to know when to rotate. You got to know the girls. And it's all by the skin of your teeth shit. You know, a chick, you got a chick's... A set ready. She comes She comes up with a CD and goes, okay, play track 2, fast forward to 33 seconds on that one, and for my second song, play track 4, and then make sure you fade it at 2:30. Pop. And then you got it. And I'm about to play it. I'm about to play her set.
What?
Some guy asked her for a lap dance. Now she goes, skip me. I got 15 seconds to find another girl and her set. So if I got 15 seconds, I would say, Candy, you're going on stage now. And I would grab the Crystal Method, Vegas. It's like Chemical Brothers. It's like Chemical Brothers. I would grab that motherfucker, boom, bam, track 4, track 8. You know what I mean? That's safe. That's a skin of your teeth set right there. So my dreams are, I'm supposed to be having a great strip club dream, a great one, but I can't remember anybody's name, so I'm all stressed out. The manager's coming up. I have these all the time. The manager's pissed. I'm going to get fired. I'm like, fuck. I can't remember shit. I can't read the CDs. The club's packed. Girls are everywhere. And it ends up being a fucking nightmare. Every time it's a nightmare. Yeah. It's never cool.
Your time is present, and you want to feed your mind with the best of what's out there. But who has time to sit through all the nonsense on the internet?
My college fans.
For those of us who want premium content and don't have the time to watch, waste finding it, there's next issue. For those of us who want premium content. and don't have time to waste finding it, there's Next Issue. Next Issue is the mobile app that lets you tap directly into the world's most popular magazines anytime, anywhere, using your phone or your tablet. They have iconic magazines like Vogue, Esquire, Time, and more. And Next Issue lets you dive deep into the story
with
interactive content for richer reading experience. Sign up for Next Issue right now. You'll get immediate access to all your top magazines. Let me tell you what they got. They got all of you. They got Condé Nast Traveler. They got Cosmopolitan for Latinas. They got Dwell. They got Ellen. They got Maxim. They got Money Sense. They got Oxygen. If there's a magazine, they got it. Do you understand me? Now do me a favor. Sign up for Next Issue right now. You'll get immediate access to all the top magazines, including back issues and exclusive videos and photos. Hey, listen, they got the best content around, like I told you. I love architecture, so I watch the One magazine. You know, what's the one thing I get? I don't even know anymore. I can't even describe myself. I like sports, so I get Sports Illustrated. Sometimes I want to find out what's going on at Entertainment Weekly. I get a bunch of stuff like that. You know, People magazine, whatever. Go to Next Issue right now. Do me that favor, right now. The best part is, Next Issue is offering you a free trial right now when you go to nextissue.com/Joey. That's the best part. Next Issue is going to offer you a free trial right now. Right now when you go to nextissue.com/Joey. Again, try Next Issue for free. Right now when you get it, nextissue.com/Joey. What happened, brother?
I'm not going to read about these people.
I don't have no idea. Whatever it takes. You know what I'm saying? I'm sitting over here. I'm sweating bullets. I got enough problems on my mind. How am I getting home?
Uber.
I ain't going to fucking Uber home.
I'm going to drive you guys home?
No.
Oh, come on, man.
I got the horse and buggy. Who do you think you're dealing with here? Where are you going to drive this fucking good enough? Look at him. He's on the floor. He's done. You want another hit to pick you up?
I can't tell if your mic's working or not. All right.
Who's Mike?
Ari's.
Does it matter? He's saying so much. Like, he's singing a fucking song.
You got a seed for this possibility.
What kind of seed for this possibility? Don't forget, also, Shroom Tech, on it. For all your supplements that you may need. I can't help you with the bodybuilding stuff and with the strength, but with the supplements, I give you 10% off your first order. You know all about on it. Right now, the best in the market. You want one of these, Alpha Brain?
Hell yeah, give me one right now.
You need a couple of these things right now. This will straight. You snort two of these, Ari, you'll be up and jumping and shit. Go to onit.com right now and press in Joey and get 10% off your first order. They've got great products. They've got Alpha Brain. They got the hemp protein, 16 grams of protein, a scoop of chocolate. It's the best chocolate out in the market. I love all this shit. I live by this stuff. So I don't know why you're not at least giving it a try. Go to onit.com right now /church, CHURCH, and get 10% off your first order. Also, the best in electronic cigarettes, hit e-cigs.com right now. They got cigars, they got cigarettes, they got 0, 8, 16, 24 milligrams, and they also have a cigar, which I've been puffing for like the last fucking 8 months.
Joey, how's the job description? He's on the floor on acid trying to fix his microphone.
I have no fucking idea.
How is the job description for your employee?
Leave this poor kid alone. Look at him. He's got money sticking out of his pants. He doesn't know if he's got a purple fucking shirt on. You think this kid's on a level? He takes Uber. He believes fucking Dirty Rock.
See, who else takes this much acid?
Who?
Sunday night.
Who takes a what? You didn't take nothing. We didn't give you nothing. We gave you 2 stars. What are you fucking crying about? Everybody's beautiful here. Go to onit.com right now /church and get 10% off your first order. Also, hit e6.com for the best e-cigarette out there. 1,200 guaranteed puffs. Who gives you that? Some fucking terrorist? Some fucking 7-Eleven? Hell no. Go to hit e6.com right now and get 5 for 50.
Also, hey, play another scene. Play another comedy scene.
Also, to my main people.
What other funny scenes are there?
NailedInLife.com. All their support and all our comedy venues.
Tell them to pull up.
They showed up and this is not happening. Heavy duty with some fucking Goomy Bears. Los Goomies are monos. They showed up blowtorching motherfuckers. I love these guys. Go to NailedInLife.com right now and press them what?
Joey Diaz.
Joey Diaz and get what? 20% off a vapor pen. The best one in the market. Just buy the fucking thing. They're such good people. You understand me? We're going to switch this over to Periscope. We love you guys. Have a great Monday morning. It is what it is, cocksuckers. Enjoy it. Stay black.
Hell yeah.
Put that up. Put Hollywood Shuffle.
Hollywood Shuffle.
No, put the music on. Put the music on, cocksucker. Close it with the music, cocksucker. Go. We're going to switch to Periscope. And we'll put Hollywood Shuffle on, whatever the fuck.
Hey, you know what? I got a piss. I'm going to use it. What key is it again?
Put the... Go to nextissue.com. Onnit.com. 86.com. NailedItLive.com. I love you motherfuckers with all my heart. See you Tuesday or Wednesday. Minneapolis this weekend. Next weekend, Fort Lauderdale Improv. The countdown to Dick Syatt continues. I'm coming back to New York. November, Stress Factory, New Jersey. Look at these two fucking set. Put the music on, Lee, goddammit. All right, have a good night, hot sucks.